Welcome back to Black Market is Open. Somebody get on Amazon and order me the fucking triangle. I'm sick of this shit. Look, man, I'm tired of y'all asking me about these kicks. And look, we just gonna put it all out there right here today, bro. What kind of black market would it be if we didn't have no shoes in there?
Facts.
What hood mall you ever went to and they didn't have four shoe stores?
Facts. Facts. That's the truth. That's the most important of the culture, man.
And look, man, I ain't even gonna introduce you, cause now it's gonna be hard to get kicks and shit. Cause now everybody gonna know who the legit plug is, bro. Just tell them, man. Tell them.
Man, look, man, y'all already know what it is, man. It's your boy, Mr. Flight Academy Kicks, man. Labeled as a celebrity sneaker plug, man. You know, this is my guy, Carlos, man. You know what I'm saying? Welcome to the 85 South Show, man. You know what I'm saying? This is my guy, man. You know what I'm saying? We got a special guest here today, man. You
man,
know what I'm saying?
It's my dog, bro. Nah, you've been on it for real, right, man. Bruh, and it's like, you know, I've been getting, I can't even remember how long I've been getting
like 2017.
Right? For real.
Minute,
it's been a long time, but look, but that's over a couple hundred pair, probably.
Yeah, facts.
For real, but it's like, man, how did you stay so true to being a legit plug all throughout the years? Cause you seen some plugs started out legit and then they flaked off, but man, you done turned this shit into a whole nother empire for real.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's perfect, cause for me, it's more than just selling sneakers. Like, it's deeper than the kicks. For me, it's about building the generational wealth and, you know, having a business. I'm very like business minded, you know, coming from the streets, you learn a lot of things in the streets that you can translate to owning a business. So for me, it was just, I didn't want to be looked at as a person who just slings shoes out the car, but right. You know, I'm actually like building an empire, because whether you believe it or not, man, sneakers are very important, bro, when it comes
especially
to the
to
fit.
A black man.
Yes, most definitely, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you're going to pick out your kicks first before you even get your clothes.
Yeah.
And sometimes when you meet people, you look at their shoes first before you even look at their face.
Right.
So, you know, having sneakers is very important. So, you know, I learned from the mistakes of other people, because there's so many people that became sneaker plugs and they started moving up that ladder, man, started being able to sell to celebrities, started making that good money, and then it started getting to them. And they never stuck to their principles, or they never stuck to the foundation that they built. You know, one of the first things, my foundation is built on God, man. So I believe in always doing business the right way, because he always gonna bless me.
Right.
So it's always deeper than that, man. And I studied the game, man. I learned from the mistakes of other people. And you know, that what makes me successful.
Man. I heard you getting ready to open up the whole store.
Yes, indeed.
Damn.
One of many.
You never gonna get shit.
Nah, man, I'ma always take care of you, man, cause you know, you took a chance on me when I was starting out in the game, bro, you know, and you gave me the opportunity and I ran with. And you don't put me on with a couple of people, bro.
Yeah, cause people be hitting me out of frustration. You know, though, you seen those Saturday mornings, yeah, bro. Motherfuckers' heart be hurting. Hey, man, if you know anybody that can get me, my baby, my sister, my mom, my auntie, yeah, we need 9 pals.
Yeah.
We need a 5 wide all the way up to a 13. But I know a few people that hit me and be like, man, thank you. I really appreciate that, bro. You got them to me.
Yeah, most definitely. I appreciate you for even doing that for me, man.
Man, shit. It's more about, like you said, the love of the game.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? I always try to make sure that people got, you know, the right information to make the right decisions.
You know, sometimes it's a bad thing too when you withhold a sneaker plug info. Cause I'm gonna tell you, when you do good business, nobody ever wanna give you up. So it kind of put like a stop to your growth a little bit. Cause I got like I sell to a lot of celebrities, bro. And they be like, nah, I can't do a shout out, bro. You know what I'm saying? Cause I'm scared. And I'm like, listen, take care of me, I'm gonna take care of you. But listen, it's some big names out there, bro. I'm telling you, every day you watch TV and you see some J's on somebody's feet, know I sold some shoes to them.
Amen.
man. It's just that serious. Especially at the award show, man, I'd be like, that's my boy. You know what I'm saying? You just don't know, but that's my guy right there. You feel me?
That's how dirty the game is, though, especially when it's like, you remember shit. I remember when motherfuckers could walk in the store and it just, shit, the Jordans was there because they was high.
Yeah.
In your size. Just everybody wasn't just able to go buy them out like that. And then the internet came, and then the resale game like blew up. And then all these apps started popping up, but it's like, man, can't nobody get shit no more.
Yeah. It come from the culture vultures, man. Like, you know, some of us, the OGs who really like the kicks, where I always tell people, sometimes when you look at a pair of Flu Games, the Flu Games mean a little different for some people. Some people, that was their first pair of shoes they got. Some people remember sitting down in front of the TV and watching the game when Jordan wore them. You know what I'm saying? But then you have, like, the younger generation who just see it as a dollar sign. And they kind of ruin the game a little bit. You know, even, you know, with me, I do the YouTube where I review the sneakers, and I always talk about that, man. I was like, you know, times are changing, but the people that's falling in love with the shoes now is more for the money. They couldn't tell you what was the story behind that shoe.
Significance.
They just know that shoe going for $500. Yeah. So they want to get it. So then you run into having to fight those people. You know what I'm saying? So, but I mean, that's why it's good when you got somebody like me, man.
The game is just at a point where it's just so stupid right now. It's like the Ben and Jerry dunks are sold out.
Mm-hmm.
Niggas can't even, niggas is lactose. You get what I'm saying? It's just the paradox of this shit.
And then, like, dunks back then were, like, just $60, man.
It was skateboarder shoes.
Yeah, now you see dunks going for $900, $1,100, you know what I'm saying, $700, $800. Like, the game changes, man, but, you know, you just got to involve with it. You know, I'll be lying if I say the way the game changed didn't help some of us, the way we advanced in life by, you know, taking this avenue. But it definitely changed a lot, man. But
that's the one thing that scared me about being a sneakerhead, though, is just thinking I'm gonna be 80 years old.
Yeah.
Where the fuck I'm gonna find me some Flu Game 12s and some 13, some Cement 3s.
They gonna come back out.
I'm gonna be wearing these shits forever.
They gonna keep coming out, man.
It's fucked up. You think they gonna make us some orthopedic J's?
I mean, you got the team Jordans.
When we can't do laces no more, they're gonna have, everything gonna have straps on. I'm clean in this bitch.
Bro.
Nah, man. Well, shit, I guess we've been talking shit long enough where you could at least tell them where to fucking hit you, man. Shit.
Look, man, look. Y'all gonna hit me on IG, man, Flight Academy. I don't know where I'm looking at, but
yeah, bro, pick a camera.
Just, you know, all right, so Flight Academy _ kicks on IG. Like you said, I am opening my first store, man, in Lakeland Mall in Lakeland, Florida. So it's gonna be Lakeland Square Mall. Yes, indeed, man. Yes, indeed. So look forward to that. And it's gonna be the first of many, man. I got a plan, so I don't want to say the cities because, you know, people watching, but, you know, they're coming here, so.
You know, we just went back on tour, and you can see we got about 1/17th of the staff here, so we're going to have to get some.
I got you.
We're going to need some boxes sent.
I got you. I'm going to make sure you get your 11 first, and then everybody else gets straight.
Yeah, bro. DC, he need a 9. Chico going to need about 11. Something like that. He wears 7 and little boys. No, I'm sure everybody's gonna drop their request and all of that shit.
You paying for everybody? Or
I just... That's how I'm gonna stay ahead of the game, bro.
Bro, what's your favorite Jordan silhouette, though?
My favorite Jordan, just the original white Cement 3s. Yeah, that's my shit. They just hit so different.
And they go with a lot, too.
And then just make it feel like you almost about to graduate college. Because those was hitting real hard around, like, when Different World was new.
Mm-hmm.
So you would always see, like, a lot of, like, Kadeem Hardison, he always had some 3s or 4s on. Like, he really was running through the Jordans before Fresh Prince.
Yeah.
Like, watching Different World. Like, Dwayne Wayne always had some fresh-ass J's.
Warren stayed fresh, too.
Hell, yeah. Him and Ron used to kick him every now and then, but Kadeem Hardison always had the J's on Different World.
Wow.
Yeah. But Fresh Prince, he wore a lot of them. Martin, busted a lot of J's.
Martin stayed fresh, man.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, it's just so part of the culture and the time that we grew up in. I don't think nothing ever gonna have the same impact, you know, to our culture as that shoe did.
Yeah.
Just watching them shits come out. Cause you remember when Mike used to have the new J's way before they came out? Mm-hmm. Like, you watching the game like, man, what the fuck is going on? Nigga, when them come out?
Yeah. He was lacing up Fresh Prince almost every night, man.
Man, having to go skip school to go get some J's.
Mm-hmm. And I think, like, everything just kind of coming back, because you look at now, the fashion, it's like back to vintage now. So the things that we're wearing in the 80s, it's coming back to it, man. So, like, it just keep going in a circle.
Man, the 80s coming back around. Niggas finna be in the club with corduroy on like a motherfucker.
It's that fashion, man.
Man, shit.
What's the most expensive pair of jeans,
sir? Carlos Miller here. With the world opening up, a lot of people are mentally uneasy about completing daily tasks in the world. Don't worry, you are not alone. Our sponsor, Talkspace, is here to help you with your mental health needs. Whether you're experiencing depression, anxiety, or other problems, Talkspace is the number one online therapy platform to help you sort through any issue. Talkspace makes it easy to match with a licensed therapist and schedule live video sessions, all from the comfort of your device. Talkspace therapists are experts in dozens of specialties, including anxiety, depression, relationships, and more to help you start feeling better. Set goals with your therapist, and they can help make sure you're really progressing. Start feeling better with a single message. Match with a licensed therapist when you go to Talkspace.com and get $100 off your first month with promo code BLACKMARKET. That's $100 off when you use promo code BLACKMARKET at Talkspace.com.
Shout out to my guy Tank, man. He sold him the Dior ones. Dior ones run about like 15 bands. So yeah. Yeah, man. So 15,000. I think that's the most. That's the most expensive one. Well,
I'll take some.
It's the retro ones, man. You gotta get you a pair in the closet.
Nah,
man.
I don't need no pair of shit like that. No, 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 no. Hell no. Nah. Ain't going nowhere, but I'm gonna need $15,000 worth of shoes on.
You know, he real high on fashion though, man. Like, he real high on fashion, man.
Well, that's a great thing to be. I'm from Mississippi. If a motherfucker even thought I paid $15,000 for some shoes, boy, you done went up there and lost your goddamn mind. What the fuck is wrong with you? I didn't raise you like that. Lost his goddamn mind. My uncle already done fucked around and went on Google and think I got $6 million. That nigga called me mad as a mother. Oh, really? Since you got $6 million motherfucking dollars, you can't send me shit, motherfucker? I was like, what are you talking about? Yeah, I seen on the internet, motherfucker say you worth $6 million.
Right.
I was like, you believe that shit? You motherfucking right. Like, oh, please stay off that shit. That is a lie.
That's crazy, man.
I am poor. That's why I work so much.
You
please,
got it, man.
Please help me. I don't have anything.
Nah, I'm just bullshitting, man. We extremely blessed, man. I hope you get to bless the streets now that they know that they got a legit plug and they don't have to worry about shit. Man, get the shit. I believe every time he hit me, he already be at the post office. Yeah, I want them. Nigga, they in the mailbox. I was like, you knew I wanted them. You just sent them or you was there already. But man, I'm just letting you know from a long-time customer, this man does great business. He ain't nothing ever failed through. If he say he got it, he got it. And if you send your money, your shit on the way. Yeah, and that's just how it goes, man. So if you live in one of those cities and you can't never get no shit, you're tired of hitting this app, you're tired of looking like everybody else, man, hit the legit sneaker plug at Flight Academy Cakes, man, and get you some exclusive shits that you can rock and get your confidence back up, because, you know, a lot of niggas missed a lot of summers.
You got to pull up to the store opening, though, man. It's the first one.
I got
to
come the day before, because I got to get all the shit I want first. Your partner already... eyeball me. Yeah, he be getting them letters.
I got you, man. We're gonna set it up, man. I'll let you be the first. You was one of the first ones that rocked with me, man. So be the first one in store.
I'm coming.
You be the first one in there, man.
Well, you send me the info and I'm in there.
Right.
I'm becoming by some of them goddamn Larry Birds. Who you think should have had a shoe? Athletes that didn't have a shoe that should have had one.
That's a tough one, bro. Because pretty much some of all of them got them, they just either went through like companies that wasn't that popular. I don't know. I'm trying to think of somebody just like off the wall. I don't know.
What y'all think? T.O. should have had a shoe. Who you say?
Rod Strickland.
Oh, I was just thinking basketball, yeah. T.O., yeah.
Hell yeah. The Kwame Brown Air Force One.
Don't want to hit, man.
Who? Triple Black. I feel like Trick Daddy should have been the ambassador of Black Air Force One.
You're right, bro. You're right.
Trick Daddy could have definitely had a shoe. At least a Reebok.
Yeah, definitely Reebok. Definitely Reebok. The Soldieries.
Ooh, Soldier Boy. Soldier Boy. Soldier Boy done did so much for the culture at this point.
But he got the baby. He was really
he needs a Nike. A regular Nike that's in rotation. Like that evolves.
Yeah, I can give you
that,
don't
man. Just need to be no one time shit.
People gotta give Soldier more credit, man.
Like, he gonna give it to himself.
Yeah. But you know what's funny with him,
he
though?
He come out every other day. Y'all niggas got me fucked up. Y'all know I had Now Ladies first.
But you know, when you go back and look at some of the stuff he's saying, he actually be telling the truth, man. Bruh, but it's so weird.
The nigga done told 95% truth. He might have slipped up and said the wrong shit once or twice.
Yeah.
But that nigga said Steve Jobs brought him his iPhone. Ain't a nigga in the world gonna top that.
How you gonna top that? Can't. That's a wrap after that.
Steve Jobs was probably sitting there. What do you think, soldier? Do we have something? Amazing. Soldier likes it. He probably had a bigger influence on the iPhone than we'll ever understand.
Thanks. Because he was at the beginning of the internet era.
What if that was how Steve Jobs used to walk in and talk to the goddamn, he got all his staff and then they standing there waiting. It's quiet. I don't know. I've never seen him before. And then next thing you hear is, you! Soldier Boy, tell him. Hi, guys. Hi, welcome to Apple.
Bro, that's crazy, man.
That was the shit he used to listen to test how the speakers was gonna sound on them. Now, so I don't know if you guys know this, but we've done some extensive research, but listening to Soulja Boy's music all the way up on an iPhone will really test to see what quality the speakers are. Nope. Look, we gotta go back to the drawing board.
Back to the drawing
board.
These
didn't pass the crank that test.
Soulja needs on iPhone, man.
Yep. It need to be black owned, too.
Yeah, facts.
Hell yeah. And it need to cost $212, flat out.
Why 212?
Because that's a great introductory price.
It's good.
They give us one summer at 212,
mm-hmm.
Then the next one that come out. Because you know he going to put a bunch of Soulja Boy shit on there. It's going to be a place to make beats. It's
going
to be a game. It's going to be a whole bunch
the
of shit that you can't take off.
Bro, that's crazy, man.
That'd be hard.
Nah, it definitely would.
Every time you get a text message, that bitch gonna be like, bow, bow.
Soldier was dropping him. Big Draco.
Man, we fucked with him the long way. That nigga from straight out of Mississippi, so he gonna be forever good with me.
Nah, facts, man.
Yeah, man. He did a lot of shit, groundbreaking. But hell, there you have it, folks. I don't know what else to give you because I done gave you everything. You got my plug now. I guess I get back to wearing these goddamn Crocs and shit.
Nah, man, you're gonna be good, bro.
Man, you don't understand these people. These niggas gonna be like, finally.
Nah, some may be mad at you, man. You gave out a plug. I'm telling you, bro, it's a lot of them that Don't want to tell nobody about me, man.
I done told them. It ain't shit else I can do, bro.
It's a wrap.
What's some of the strangest, before we get out of here, what's some of the strangest requests that people have hit you for? You like, you want them?
You know what it is, man? People always just find pictures on the internet and just think every shoe is real. Like, it just be like the weirdest shoes, man. I be like, I ain't never seen that before. Like, they just Google, they'll put in a color in a shoe and then whatever pop up, can you get me these?
Oh,
like,
I bought
nah,
some.
That ain't even a real shoe.
I know I bought some shit that ain't available because I had saw this nigga on, you know how shit just pop up on your feed? He was just like fed up with not being able to get shit, so he just started like making his own custom shit.
Yeah.
Man, this nigga made some fucking Yeezy Air Maxes.
I think
me and him the only ones got some.
Yeah, most
bro,
definitely.
When I tell you these bitches is so cold. Or
for real?
I seen a picture. These motherfuckers so cold. I was like, bro, make me the great pair too. I'm going to send them to you. I don't know if you've seen these before.
That, man.
I might bust them bitches out, but they cold as fuck. And the bottoms glow.
You going to wear them out in public?
Yeah. Because it's not like they's some knockoffs.
He just did a custom.
They just custom.
Got you.
That shit went exactly how I planned it to go. All right, man, y'all stay tuned. The black market is now open. Yeah. Flight Academy kicks. Get your shit for real. It's legit. We out of here.
Yes, sir. Most definitely.